This is our hen house where our adult hens live. We do have one male in here. And the only reason he's in here is I really like him a lot. He's a Schofield Silver and he's super, super sweet. And the ladies like him as well. And this is the area where we keep just our egg-laying hens. This structure has a sand floor. We rake it out once a week. We add new piles of sand. We buy it by the truckload, actually. I believe we pay $22 for a yard, which is quite a bit of sand. We put in old stumps, branches, twigs, and then grasses and meadow grasses and anything else on the property we're cutting down so we can have these little fairy huts in here for the girls, and they like to lay their eggs underneath these structures. This outside area has hardware netting, and so it gets rain, sun, wind, snow, all the elements. A nice big water. This is our little feeding area where we have crushed eggshells, oyster shells, and then these food boxes are the best solution we've found so far, but you can see that even with these, they do kick out quite a bit of food. And then back here, which I love, so this area right here will get hardwood panels in the winter time to stop the wind from coming through. But this interior section is passive solar. It has greenhouse siding on it. It's actually quite warm. It's about 110 degrees in here right now. We put down pine shavings and chopped straw with zeolite in the wintertime. We have airflow through that vent in the back, and we also have time lights for the wintertime. Where we live, we only get about 6 hours of true daylight in the wintertime, so we do turn on artificial lighting. So the girls get about 14 hours total of light during the day in the winter time. But this area is about 20 degrees warmer than it is outside, even in the winter time. It doesn't get a straight up wind, but it does have nice airflow. And our girls do lovely all winter, all spring, all summer, all fall. And the ladies have this beautiful natural enclosure. And I think it actually makes them a lot calmer. And because they're not in cages, we've never had a problem with bumblefoot or cut feet or ripped claws in any way. Here's one of my beautiful, sweet champion egg layer quails. She's amazing. And just like our flight pen, our hen house has a latch on the inside and a handle. So when I'm in here, I can latch it and the door doesn't accidentally blow open. The bonus of having our hen house right at the edge of our garden here is our garden attracts grasshoppers, caterpillars, worms, and it's really fun in the evening to collect those bugs for them and put them in their enclosure. And it's just extra nutrition from them, and it kind of is like our quail and our garden are working together. So I really love that. We have a door on the greenhouse side of the hen house, and we take that off when we need to clean out this part of the structure.